Friends in Norfolk, how are you doing?
Great. How are you?
So good to be back here at the Federated Church for the second year that I've done this. I've really missed you all, and can't believe it's been a year since the last time I did a show here. So, yeah, it's good to see you all again. My name is Matt Savage. I'm a pianist. I do jazz professionally, but I'd like to start with a few classical things. First, I'm going to start with this Mozart sonata in A minor, sonata number 8, K310, I guess, although in this book it's called Sonata 14 for some reason. So it forms a perfect transition from the last song that Miss Katie did so wonderfully, because it's the same key and about the same tempo, but things get very different from there. This is, unlike the sonata that contains the rondo alla turca, this sonata is entirely in key of A minor. And it's a stormy one because it was written right after the death of Mozart's mother. So this piece is kind of a difficult time in his life. But true to Mozart's form, it's one of the, it's still pretty bouncy, but it's got some dark flourishes that you might not necessarily expect. And the movements, the three movements are vastly different tempo and vastly different length. So hope you enjoy this one.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Specifically to showcase one side of the technique. And so you'll hear a lot of sections that kind of repeat the same pattern in the left hand, for example. But for this one, I wanted to get intense right from the get-go, sort of give things the Michael Bay treatment. because some pieces take a while to get started with their intensity or their relentless nature, but not this one. This is going to be loud, and then later on things will get quieter and faster and slower and weird. So I hope you enjoy this one. Yeah. By the way, the key of that last sonata is all white keys, A minor, and key of this is as many black keys as possible.
Thank you.
to her recently departed master of the piano. See you soon.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna get going with the second half here. Yes, sorry, I was late. But I can't tell you how excited I am to be here to hear Matt play. I hear it was an amazing first half. And this second half, we're going to hear a lot of jazz standards. It's gonna be an amazing thing, so please welcome back Matt Travis to the stage. Thank you.
there is called I Love You, the greatest and simplest title of them all. And it's by Cole Porter, of course one of the great Broadway composers of the 20th century. And the legend about that one goes that Cole Porter's friend made a bet with him that he couldn't write a hit with words like "It's Spring Again" and "Birds on the Wing Again," and have a and have the title of the tune just be "I Love You." But certainly Cole Porter wrote more than a sophisticated enough tune to match. I'm going to do a tribute to the late pianist McCoy Tyner pretty soon. He was the last surviving member of the John Coltrane Quartet, and he just passed away today. So his influence on the not just jazz, but the very essence of piano playing in the last 60 years, it's incalculable. So do that in a little bit. Do a couple of changes from the program I was going to perform. But first, I'd like to do most seasonal song of them all. It's by the French film composer Michel Legrand, and it's called You Must Believe in Spring.
Thank you.
Davis classic, popularized by the Bill Evans Trio. It's called Nardis. Nobody's quite sure whether it's this person whose last name was Sidran. People aren't quite sure whether it was Sidran's name spelled backwards or if it's I'm a Nardis with a Jersey accent. probably the former. So I'd like to conclude with a couple of pieces in tribute to McCoy Tyner. And I'll start with a John Coltrane quartet piece. This is one of Coltrane's originals, originally played on the soprano sax, with McCoy Tyner on piano, Jimmy Garrison on bass, and Elvin Jones on drums. So it was his classic quartet. And this is a ballad called Central Park West.
Thank you.
ballads period. It's a historic piece, Peak Coltrane Quartet, McCoy, of course. And I'd like to conclude for now with one of the pieces from McCoy Tyner's own albums as a leader. This one's from a quartet album that's appropriately titled The Real McCoy, because how could it not be called The Real McCoy? This one, it's with a different band. It's with Joe Henderson on sax. It's also a quartet, but it's McCoy Tyner's quartet. So this is one of his most famous pieces, and in tribute to this master gone too soon, this one is called Contemplation. It's a waltz with a simple melody, but it's a good showcase for a lot of the intense chords with lots of fourths in them that McCoy Tyner was so fond of.